So Paul, what do you guys do to actually get out of the way when you're testing with a user? You know, what questions do you ask them, or what statements do you give them to make sure they're comfortable just taking the product as it is?
So by far the most important one is to make sure that the user knows that we are not testing them, we are testing the software. Mm-hmm. We will actually often make that just 100% explicit, say we are not testing you, we are testing the program. If you feel like you're doing something wrong, you're not. Our program is doing something wrong. Mm-hmm. Then we kind of step back and let them start using the software. Mm-hmm. The other thing that we do during tests, which is really important, is to have the user think aloud. Mm-hmm. So thinking aloud is a little bit different than just talking or just thinking, right? One of the best ways that I've found to get a user to think aloud, or to understand what thinking aloud is to ask them how many windows they have in their house or their apartment. Mm-hmm. And most people will say, 4. And you go, okay, well, hang on. Walk me through the process of how you got there. Right. And the user will go, well, I guess there are, you know, 2 in the kitchen, and then I turn left, and there's another little one there, so it's 3, and then I go upstairs, and I guess there's a couple windows on the staircase, and you're like, okay, that's the process that we want you to go through.
Right.
We want to know what you're thinking as you're thinking, what you're noticing, what you're understanding, when you realize something, we want to know that.
Right.
And then as the test goes on, you kind of keep poking them and keep prompting them. Mm-hmm. And if they start to get frustrated, you go back and remind them again, this is great information for us, you're doing nothing wrong, this is exactly what we want to know.
Yep.